Can fake meat save the world? Because as of right now, raising animals for food is a major contributor to climate change, responsible for an estimated 14.5% of all global emissions. If the climate science is believed, we are in serious trouble. And let's be serious, Americans will never stop eating meat, unless the fake stuff tasted just as good as the real thing.
What do you think? Do you think fake meat is the answer? Continue watching.
I'm food and agriculture reporter Dina Shanker, and I want to see what it will take to get 300 million Americans to eat a fake burger. This is At What Cost? We don't live in a dystopian hellscape quite yet, forcing us all to eat alternative meat, but a lot of people are doing it anyway.
The Impossible Burger.
It tastes like beef, but it's not meat.
I'll make some of these at the family reunion.
While 95% of Americans still eat meat, sales of substitutes to replace animal products are up and now comprise a $3.7 billion market, up 20% since last year. Fake meat falls into three meat buckets.
Can fake meat save the world? You decide.
There's plant-based fake meat, like the Impossible Burger and Beyond Burger, meant to mimic meat. And then plant-based burgers that the companies say do not mimic meat, but taste great on their own.
Now, I haven't tried these burgers, but I've made my own veggie burgers that were actually pretty tasty. As far as fake meat, I don't really go along with that. I think there's a lot of great recipes for your own veggie burger, but I digress. Continue the video.
Like the old school garden burger. Finally, there is lab grown, or as the industry calls it, clean meat, where they literally grow the meat in a lab from cells like Memphis Meats is doing.
It's weird meat, you know, I think it's like science fiction meat.
It's weird meat.
But technically, it's meat.
That's Kate Crater, Bloomberg's food critic.
I think the jury's out on that one.
This type of meat is not on the market yet. Of course, the elephant in the room is, does this stuff actually taste good? Kate has had the Impossible Burger before, and we asked her how they tasted.
How do they taste? I think it depends on whether you are a dedicated meat eater.
Notice how she didn't say, oh, they taste great. I think it depends on whether you're a dedicated meat eater. That means it tastes like shit.
Whether you're a vegetarian who wants to feel like you're eating a real beef burger, I think that...
So if you feel like you want to eat a real burger and you eat that, then you'll have a different opinion in the flavor. The thing is, it's bullshit. It tastes like shit. They're just playing it up. Here we go.
The Impossible Burger is a little bit sweet, but the way a lot of smart chefs have counteracted that is to sear it really well. So if you sear it in a pan, not only do you get that really good texture sense of a real burger, but it also caramelizes the sugar.
Looks had the magical sound in the background. Oh yeah, it's magical. It's so good. When you sear it, it tastes so much better.
That's in an Impossible Burger, and so it actually maximizes. They take something that could be a negative and make it a positive.
So what do you see as the single biggest factor of getting people to switch from their beef burgers to their Impossible or Beyond Meat burgers?
Economics is going to play a big role because certainly most people are not going to pay $18 for an Impossible burger. Like that's when the novelty factor is big for an audience. So I think economics is going to play a huge factor in it because I do.
That means that people who have money will be able to get those laboratory grown fake meat burgers, and they're going to benefit and it's going to help them. It's basically because all of our meats are going to be rotten with all the antibiotics and contaminants and E. coli and all the poisoned Monsanto vegetables. And this is their answer to a clean meat diet.
I really believe that the world is moving towards a less meat-based diet.
You're eating this without knowing. You wouldn't know.
No.
You wouldn't.
One thing that may surprise you is the calorie count.
The way the calorie counts stack up is sort of questionable. Impossible Foods has come in as slightly more high calorie and more saturated fat than a regular 3-ounce.
So we got more calories, more fat, and we're trying to prevent obesity, but we're going to stuff you with fake meat that has more calories and significantly more saturated fat, like double the amount, 10% or 10 grams versus 5.1. It's the Impossible Burger.
That's what research shows, but it's still, a plant-based diet, no doubt, is better than eating like big burgers every day of your life.
But is that really true?
I have a big problem.
No, I think eating big burgers every day of your life is going to be 10 times healthier, at least half, according to their statistics, that you can eat regular burgers and have half the amount of saturated fats and calories, but I digress.
This is Ariane Dagan, the owner CEO of D'Artagnan Fine Foods, who is skeptical of the merits of fake meat, to say the least.
At the level of technology today, there are things in there that I cannot pronounce, and that's a problem.
But if it comes down to whether fake meat will ever take over real meat, don't count on it.
I haven't heard any meat companies express anxiety. This market is a drop in the bucket compared to the larger protein market. Right now, the cell-based...
Try to make it sound good.
...product. Aren't really cheap enough for mass consumption. That's one of their problems.
It's not cheap enough for mass consumption, and we need cheaper meats for the poor people so that the poor people can eat all the fake meat and only the rich will get the better plant-based burger.
Bring down the price before they can really compete.
People are more and more concerned and educated about what they put in their body, and they should do that. And so as long as they are doing that and they get more educated also on the taste of it, companies like D'Artagnan will be thriving.
So once they normalize the flavor of this fake meat and people think of it as normal, like they'll give it to their kids and their kids grow up and it'd be like, yeah, that's regular meat. No, it's fake. And that's what they're doing, so.
I am my own competitor. I want to raise a better species, a better animal, always. There are always ways to make it better.
Yeah, like with chemicals and growing your meat in a laboratory. That's better, and we're going to make that a good thing, and everybody loves it, right? Yeah, fake meats. Yummy. Just get used to it.
And that's what we're striving for.
That sounds great for the people who can afford expensive and responsibly raised meat. But for those who can't, fake meat can very well be in your future.
Yay, fake meats!